Hello, this is Dr. Carlo Oller, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. To find videos like this related to the care of emergency care patients, please come to edexitvideo.com.
Hello, today I'm going to talk to you about vertigo. Vertigo is the feeling that you or your environment is moving or spinning. It differs from dizziness in that vertigo describes an illusion of movement. When you feel as if you or yourself are moving, it is called subjective vertigo. And perception that your surroundings are moving, it's called objective vertigo. Unlike nonspecific lightheadedness or dizziness, vertigo has relatively fewer causes. What are the causes of vertigo? Vertigo can be caused by problems in the brain or the inner ear. Benign paroxysmal positional vertigo, or BPPV, is the most common form of vertigo and is characterized by the sensation of motion initiated by sudden head movements or moving the head in certain direction. This type of vertigo is rarely a serious disease and can be treated very easily. Vertigo may also be caused by inflammation within the inner ear or labyrinthitis or vestibular neuritis, which is characterized by sudden onset of vertigo and may be associated with hearing loss. The most common cause of labyrinthitis is a viral or bacterial inner ear infection. Many ERS disease is composed of a triad of symptoms, including episodes of vertigo, ringing in the ear or tinnitus, and hearing loss. People with this condition have abrupt onset of severe vertigo, fluctuating hearing loss, as well as periods in which their symptoms are completely gone. An acoustic neuroma is a type of tumor in the nerve tissue that causes vertigo. Symptoms include vertigo with one-sided ringing in the ear and hearing loss. Vertigo can be caused by decreased blood flow to the base of the brain or cerebellum. Bleeding into the back of the brain or cerebellar hemorrhage is characterized by vertigo, headache, difficulty walking, and inability to look towards the side of the bleed. The result is that the person's eyes gaze away from the side of the problem, and walking is also extremely impaired. Vertigo is often the presenting symptom with multiple sclerosis. The onset is usually abrupt, and the examination of the eyes may reveal inability of the eyes to move past the midline towards the nose. Head trauma and neck injury may also result in vertigo, which usually goes away on its own. Migraine, a severe form of headache, may also cause vertigo. The vertigo is usually followed by a headache. There is often a prior history of similar episodes, but no lasting complications or long-term problems. Complications from diabetes can cause arteriosclerosis or hardening of the arteries, which can then lead to lower blood flow in the brain, causing vertigo. Vertigo symptoms. Vertigo implies that there is a sensation of motion, either of the person or the environment, often perceived as if the room is spinning around you. This should not be confused with symptoms of lightheadedness or fainting. Vertigo differs from motion sickness in that motion sickness is a feeling of being off balance and lacking equilibrium caused by repeated motions such as riding in a car or boat. If true vertigo exists, symptoms include a sensation of disorientation or motion. In addition, the individual may also have any or all of the following symptoms: nausea or vomiting, sweating, which we term diaphoresis, abnormal eye movements, which we call nystagmus, and the eyes flutter. The duration of the symptoms can be from minutes to hours, and symptoms can be constant or episodic. The onset may be due to a movement or change in position. It is important to tell the doctor about any recent head trauma or whiplash injury, as well as any new medications that affected the individual is taking. The person may have hearing loss and ringing sensation in the ears. The person might have visual disturbance, weakness, difficulty speaking, and decreased level of consciousness and difficulty walking. When to seek medical care for vertigo. Any signs and symptoms of vertigo warrant an evaluation by a doctor. The majority of the cases of vertigo are harmless and can wait to see your regular doctor. Although vertigo can be debilitating, most causes are easily treated with prescription medication, like meclizine. Have a doctor check any new signs or symptoms of vertigo to rule out rare, potentially serious, or life-threatening causes like a stroke. Certain signs and symptoms of vertigo may require an evaluation in the hospital's emergency department. These are double vision, headache, weakness, difficulty speaking, abnormal eye movements or fluttering, altered level of consciousness, not acting appropriately, or difficulty arousing the person from sleep, difficulty walking or controlling the arms or legs. What tests are done in the evaluation of vertigo? Well, primarily a physical exam and medical history. The history is comprised of four basic areas. The doctor may want to know if the patient feels any sensation or motion which may indicate true vertigo exists. Report any nausea, vomiting, sweating, and abnormal eye movements. The doctor may ask how long the patient's had the symptoms and whether they are constant or come and go. Do the symptoms occur when moving or changing position? Is the patient currently taking medications that are new? Has there been any recent head trauma or whiplash injury? Are there any other hearing symptoms? Specifically, report any ringing in the ears or hearing loss. Does the patient have other neurological symptoms like weakness, visual disturbance, altered level of consciousness, difficulty walking, abnormal eye movements, or difficulty speaking, as this will indicate a more severe disease? The doctor may also perform tests like a CT scan if a brain injury is suspected to be the cause of vertigo or if he suspects a tumor or bleed. Blood tests to check blood sugar levels and the use of an electrocardiogram, ECG, to look at the heart rhythm may also be helpful. Treatment of vertigo. The choice of treatment will depend on the diagnosis or the underlying cause of the spinning sensation. Vertigo can be treated with medication taken by mouth, through medicine placed on the skin like a patch, or drugs given through an IV. Specific types of vertigo may require additional treatment and referrals, like to a neurologist, neurosurgeon, and so on. Bacterial infection of the middle ear will require antibiotics. For Meniere's disease, in addition to symptomatic treatment, people may be placed on low-salt diet and may require medication used to increase urine output and get rid of fluid. A hole in the inner ear causing recurrent infections may require a referral to an ear, nose, and throat doctor, an ENT specialist, because they can do surgery to repair this hole. In addition to the drugs used for benign procedures, vestibular rehabilitation exercises, also referred to as Epley maneuver, consists of having the patient sit on the edge of the table, lie down towards one side until the vertigo resolves, followed by sitting up, and then laying down again to the other side, again until the vertigo goes away. This is repeated until the vertigo no longer recurs. Particle reposition maneuver is a treatment based on the idea that the condition is caused by displacement of tiny stones inside the bowel center or vestibular system in the inner ear. The head is repositioned to move the stones to their normal position. This maneuver is repeated until the abnormal eye movements are no longer visible, the nystagmus. Commonly prescribed medications for vertigo include the following: meclizine hydrochloride or antivert, diphenhydramine or Benadryl, scopolamine transdermal patch or transderm scop, promethazine hydrochloride or Phenergan, diazepam or Valium. These medications should be taken only as directed and under the supervision of a doctor. Follow-up. Anyone with a new diagnosis of vertigo should follow up with his or her doctor or be referred directly to a neurologist or ENT specialist. How to prevent vertigo? Well, people whose balance is affected by vertigo should take precautions to prevent injuries from falls. Those with risk factors for stroke should control their high blood pressure, high cholesterol levels, and stop smoking. What is the prognosis of this disease? Well, the prognosis really depends on the source of the vertigo. Vertigo caused by problems in the inner ear, while usually self-limited, in some cases can become completely incapacitating to the patient. The use of drugs and rehabilitation exercise is the mainstay of therapy. Most commonly, this will make the symptoms completely go away or make the condition tolerable. The prognosis of vertigo from a brain lesion depends on the amount of damage done to the central nervous system, and vertigo caused by a brain lesion may need emergency evaluation by a neurologist and or a neurosurgeon. This is it for my discussion of vertigo. For specific videos about the specific causes of vertigo, like meniere's and brain tumors and acoustic neuromas, you can search my website for those videos and watch them individually. Thank you for watching. We'll see you soon.